Hello friends, how are you? Welcome to About Studies. Today our topic of discussion is transport proteins. We will learn what are transport proteins, what are the types of transport proteins, and what is their mechanism and all these things. Firstly, let us understand what are transport proteins. Transport proteins are nothing but the proteins that transport ions or substances across the membrane. It means they mediate the transportation of ions, water molecules, and various glycerin molecules, amino acids, etc. We learn all these things. Example, calcium ion channels, sodium potassium pumps, uniporters, etc. We learn these things individually later on. Before going to know about transport proteins, let us learn what is transportation and how many types of transportation are there. There are two kinds of transportations. One is passive transport and another is active transport. Passive transport is again classified into two types. There are simple diffusion and facilitated diffusion. Simple diffusion means transportation of molecules from higher to lower concentration areas without the requirement of transport proteins. Whereas the facilitated diffusion is also a kind of diffusion which requires no ATP molecules and requires transport proteins. The another kind of active transportation is active transport. This kind of transportation requires ATP molecules for transporting the ions or molecules. Let us learn how many types of transport proteins. There are majorly three classes of transport proteins. They are channels, pumps, and transporters. Firstly, let us discuss what are channels. Channels are the instruments of passive transport. It means, as we have earlier learned, that passive transport requires no ATP molecules, and it is again classified into two types, simple diffusion. Likewise, channels comes under passive transport, which requires no ATP molecules but requires transport proteins, means they comes under facilitated diffusion. They transport the things, ions or molecules, along the gradient. It means they transport the ions from higher to lower concentration areas. Let me explain the working of channels with the help of diagram. In this diagram, we are able to see a lipid bilayer. This is the membrane, lipid bilayer. The ion or molecule is being passed from one side to another side of lipid bilayer. It means higher to lower concentration area. This is called concentration gradient. When there is only one vertex, it is called lower concentration area. When there are two vertices on one side of a lipid bilayer, this is called higher concentration area. It means the ion or water molecule is being passed across the plasma membrane from higher to lower concentration area. This is the working mechanism of channel. There are two kinds of channels. They are water channels or aquaporins and ion channels. Water channels transport water molecules, whereas ion channels transport the ions like sodium, potassium, calcium, etc. There is a new term called gating mechanism. What is gating mechanism? It is a process where when an ion or water molecule comes to the channel, it opens. Generally, the channels are in closed condition. Whenever the substrate like ion or water molecule comes to the channel, then it gets opened and the transportation occurs. This is about the channels. Now let us discuss the second type of transport proteins. They are pumps. Pumps are the instruments of active transport. It means they require the ATP molecules for transportation, whereas the channels don't require ATP molecules. The pumps require ATP. These utilize external energy for the transportation of ions or molecules. The channels require no external energy. This external energy is provided by the passive transport. It means whenever an electron jumps from higher orbital to lower orbital, certain amount of energy is released. In the same way, in channels, when the ions or molecules are passing from higher to lower concentration areas, certain amount of energy is released. That energy is utilized by the pumps for transporting the ions or molecules. Thus, it utilizes the external energy from released by the passive transport. The pumps work against the gradient. It means they transport the things from lower to higher concentration areas. Based on the source of energy, there are four types of pumps. One is light driven pumps, which requires photons as energy. The second type is EMF driven pumps, which require electromotive force as a source of energy. EMF driven pumps, which require protons as energy, and ATP driven pumps. ATP means they require ATPs for as a source of energy. These ATP driven pumps are also called as ATPases. Why? Because these enzymes, ATPases, break down the ATP into ADP and PI, and that's why they are considered as ATPases. Pumps generally do coupled reactions. Coupled reaction means two reactions at one time. What are those two reactions? The first reaction is ATP is converted to ADP and PI. As it is active transport, so it requires energy as in the form of ATP. So ATP is converted to ADP and PI. The second reaction in coupled reaction is transport of substance across the membrane. With this energy released, it transports the substance, that is ion or water molecule, from lower concentration to higher concentration area. Those are the two reactions done by the pumps. See, here the lower concentration area is one vertex, two vertices are for higher concentration area. The ion or molecule, water molecule, is passing from lower to higher, that is against the gradient, that is different to the opposite to the channel. Let us go through the third class of transport proteins. They are transporters. Transporters are the substances which undergo conformational change to mediate the transportation process. There are three kinds of transporters. They are uniporters, symporters, and antiporters. Uniporters transport only a single kind of substance, whereas antiporters and symporters mediate the transportation of two or more substances. We'll learn with the help of diagram. Now, here, let us learn what are uniporters. Uniporters are a kind of arrangements of passive transport. It means they require no ATP molecules. It comes under facilitated diffusion. It means it requires the transport proteins for the transportation process. Role. What is the role of transport uniporters? Only one type of molecule or one group of molecules are transported across the bilayer. They are also called as single solute carriers or single solute carriers, since they are transporting only one kind of substance. The difference here, on listening these four points, we can understand that uniporters are also working like channels. It means they are also requiring transport proteins. They require no ATP molecules, and they are transporting only one kind of molecule. Then what is the difference? What is the major difference between uniporters and channels? The difference is the channels transport only ions like sodium, potassium, calcium, like this, whereas the uniporters transports the amino acids, glycerin molecules, and glucose molecules. Like these substances are transported through uniporters. That is the main difference between uniporters and channels. Let us learn the another kind of transporters. They are symporters and antiporters. The symporters and antiporters transport minimum two substances. In the previous transport proteins, we have observed only one kind of substances are transported, whereas in symporters and antiporters, two substances are transported at a time. One is actively transported and the other is passively transported. It means one requires ATP and other doesn't require ATPs. Here, this is the transport protein called symporter. Here we can observe two substances are being passed across the bilayer. One is passively transported, which requires no ATP molecules. One is actively transported, which is require ATP molecules. See, in antiporters, two substances are being passed across the bilayer with the help of antiporter transport protein. One is actively transported, so one is passively transported, higher concentration area to lower concentration area, whereas another requires another is passing from lower concentration area to higher concentration area. This is active and this is passive. Here, this is passive and this is active. That is the role of symporters and antiporters. These transporters are also called as co-transporters. Symporters. The difference between symporters and antiporters is symporters pass the molecules in same direction, whereas antiporters pass the molecules in opposite directions. This is about the transport proteins, types and their mechanisms. Please give your valuable feedback in comment section. Thank you, friends.